Dr. Oz checks in. Next, Rachel.
Weekdays at 2 on Channel 3.
Chattanooga Allergy Clinic, now open for Saturday shots in Hickson and Lee Highway.
Month, we focus on colorectal cancer, a type of cancer that affects millions and millions of Americans every year. The good news is it can be treated. The better news is it can be prevented. Dr. Sean Rice is a gastroenterologist new in town. He is with Erlanger Hospital, and he joins us this morning. Good to see you.
Good to see you, too. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I'm very glad to have you. So here you are. You've come into town on the cusp of a pandemic, joined a practice, and saving lives at the same time. So welcome to town.
Thank you so much.
So let's talk a little bit about the facts of colorectal cancer. I guess the best news is we can talk about it openly now. There was a time when we were kind of hesitant to even say the words.
Yeah, that's true. It's definitely become a more popular concept to talk about in the healthcare community and among patients, and it's we have now a whole month dedicated to it, which is this month is Colorectal Cancer Awareness Month, and most importantly, just getting the word out about screening techniques and information about who should be screened is most important.
So, as a gastroenterologist, are you the first step in screening, Dr. Rice, or is it typically your primary care doctor who will then perhaps send you on to a gastroenterologist?
Yeah, most importantly, probably meeting with the primary care doctor, and the primary care doctor can offer you a certain number of tests. There's non-invasive ways to screen depending on risk status, but eventually he or she will refer you to a gastroenterologist to consider the colonoscopy as well.
Is 50 still that kind of magical age when you should begin the screening process?
Yeah, that's a great question. So recently, we just actually shifted it back. So 50 was what we'd done for many years, and the data does suggest that there is some benefit from starting at age 45 in all individuals.
Is that true whether you have a history of colorectal cancer in your family or not?
So another great question. And so that guideline is recommended for average risk individuals. And so average risk includes those with no symptoms, no family history, and no prior history of polyps on colonoscopies. So that guideline only applies to average risk. If you do have a history of colon cancer in your family, it gets a little more nuanced. And so meeting with your gastroenterologist is an important task in figuring out when your actual first screen should be.
Do we see more cases and talk more about colon cancer today because we're just able to diagnose it better? Or are we seeing more cases of it because of the American diet?
So that's complicated. I suspect, and what we think is probably happening is that we are seeing a younger age of onset and diagnosis of colon cancer. It's complex, but probably has something to do with the environment, diet being one of the components of that. Family history, among other things, also plays a role. But I do suspect there is probably some environmental exposure that is increasing some risk.
I say the wrong thing on the air all the time. So if I goofed in introducing you, you are more than welcome to correct me, and I will not be offended, I promise. But was I wrong in saying that colon cancer can be prevented?
So you're not wrong. No, that's actually the beauty of this test. When we do a screen, we're looking for these precancerous growths called polyps. And a polyp takes about 10 to 30 years to eventually grow into a cancer. And so if we find these when they're small enough, you can remove them with the colonoscope and essentially prevent a colon cancer.
Okay, so when you go and you get a screening and the doctor comes back and says, well, we found some polyps, that's almost to be expected depending on the age you are, right?
Correct. About 20 to 30% of first-time average risk screening colonoscopies should have polyps. Depending on your gender, it's different for men and women, but somewhere in there, generally, if you think about the average, about a quarter of patients will have at least one polyp, maybe more. So it's very common.
Are there some people who just, for whatever reason, can't go through a colonoscopy, and if they don't want to or they can't do it, are there other options available for them?
So if you don't want to do a colonoscopy, yes, there are non-invasive tests, and that is something that you may see on TV, like the Cologuard or the FIT tests. Those are home tests that you send a stool sample in for that can be ordered by your primary care doctor. If you are not healthy enough to undergo colonoscopy, that's a different story. And again, more nuanced, and probably meeting with your gastroenterologist is a good discussion to have. But the caveat with all this testing of non-invasive colon cancer screening is that if it's positive, you will need a colonoscopy after the fact to look further.
Okay. There was a time, too, when it was very common to say, oh, I'm going to take a day off from work because my husband and my wife has to go in for their colonoscopy. I've got to take them back and forth to the hospital. Yeah. If you're a single person, is that a concern for you? I mean, I guess you can't drive yourself back and forth because you're sedated?
Yeah, and so that still holds true. We do require that everyone has a ride. We do put you to sleep for the procedure with an anesthesiologist. It is required that you have a ride there and back for safety. So that is still an issue that is an ongoing issue today, which presents many problems for some people. But there's workarounds, and we work with patients as best we can to be able to ensure that they can safely get their screening colonoscopies.
I focused our conversation completely on the cancer side of it and the preventive nature with the colonoscopies. And about a minute or so left, in your practice, you do see people for all types, though, of digestive issues, correct?
Correct.
And are you taking patients? Are you taking new patients?
Yeah, currently accepting new patients. We just moved into the city of 6-7 months ago, so building the practice up and happy to accept patients for a variety of issues, not necessarily just colon screening. We see anything from abdominal pain, inflammatory bowel disease, pancreas problems, liver problems, gastric problems, heartburn, that type of stuff. So a lot of different issues that we see in gastroenterology.
Well, welcome to Chattanooga. Thank you for your time. And I'll tell you what, if you can move here, have a new baby, settle in, and make your way to come on TV, I think you can conquer anything. So thank you so much for your time.
Yeah, thank you so much. Thanks for having me.
You can get in touch with Dr. Sean Rice. He's part now of the Erlanger Health System. The phone number to call is 778-7000, or even better yet, 778-4830. That's the phone number into his office, practicing downtown, and also over at Erlanger East. We are back after this.
Seems like CBD stores are popping up.